Today we're going to talk about something that may be magic to some, others it may just be the normal course of building a motor, but it's porting a cylinder head. You've already upgraded exhaust, carburetor, maybe even a cam. Now what you want to do is get the most efficiency you can and the better flowing heads. This is a traditional small block Chevy here. This happens to be an aluminum one. And your exhaust ports here and your intake are pretty much just sand cast as is. What we want to show you is how you can port these heads and polish them. And what we have here is a cutaway of the same cast iron small block Chevy. And what we're going to do is eliminate the flash that's on here and the rough cast and smooth the airflow. What this will do is it'll increase CFM, but it'll also give the air a little bit more linear path coming down in there. All right, what you have in front of you here is the Eastwood cylinder head porting kit. Comes with an assortment of 80 grit abrasive rolls. You have your straight roll here, which gets you into the floor and the ceiling and the sides of the port a lot easier. And then you have your tapered. This will get you into some of the tighter areas in the radius. Also, what we include are 2 4-inch mandrels and 2 6-inch mandrels. All right, what we want to do is take the mystery out of porting. It's really not that difficult, and the benefits are far rewarding and measurable. Even a very simple porting job can give you anywhere from 2 to 11 CFM increase. First thing you want to do, start with, this is a big block Chevy that we have here. This is the intake side. Take your intake gasket, simply use a couple bolts here to just temporarily hold it in place. And what we're going to do is scribe the gasket area itself. Around each point, just take a carbide scribe. So what we have on here is we have a scribe line of areas of the metal that we want to remove. And one thing you want to do when you're porting is remember, don't remove too much metal. What you want to do is simply smooth the casting area itself. Bring the metal, the opening out here to your gaskets, and then stay about a half inch back from the valve seat. What you want to do is start off with what's included in the kit is the 6-inch roll here. Now what you can do to speed stuff, especially on cast iron heads, is we have carbide burrs. You can purchase carbide burrs in a 3-inch length and a 6-inch length. What these will do is just speed up the time. Simply start working around the port itself. You don't want to focus just in one area there, because what you're going to start doing is you're going to start really misshaping the port itself. So continue around, continue to go deeper, deeper inside of the port. Now again, you can't do a lot of damage if all you're doing is smoothing the metal and not trying to reshape and remove a lot. But where you do want to watch, I'll simply fit this pig over. The valve seats themselves, you want to stay back a half inch. Now what a lot of guys will do is get into the bowl area here and start blending, which is fine, you can do that. One thing you have to remember is any minute material you're removing here is actually lowering your compression ratio. So what I like to do is just get a feel to see if there's any heavy casting flash. And if you do find an area, simply blend him out. But most importantly when you're on this side is this area right around here, around the combustion chamber. This tends to be very shot from the machining operation on the heads here. So what you want to do with a used roll is just gently break that edge. Just take one pass around there. What it'll do is it'll eliminate any of those sharp corners, which will actually add to pre-ignition. They'll turn into literally glow plugs with heat there. All right, we're gonna start the porting operation now. What we're gonna do is we're gonna start in the combustion chamber area. Like we said earlier, you wanna stay away from the valve seat area here. What you do wanna notice is there's a sharp ridge, about a half inch, maybe 5/8 below the valve seat itself. And this, just by the nature of the casting, leaves a step or a sharp edge. So what we're gonna do is go in there with our roll and start blending and smoothing that out. And again, you don't have to remove a lot of metal. What you want to do here is just break any of your sharp edges. You want to have nice laminar airflow through here. So what we're going to do is just gently start with the carbide burr. Again, this is an accessory that you can buy through Eastwood here. All it does is speed up the process. And then you'll see a switch back to between the tapered and the regular straight rolls through the operation. Stop, check your work frequently. Again, you're looking for continuous blending and not so much just heavy metal removal. What we're doing here is just going in with the 6-inch mandrel on here and a tapered roll, going into the bottom, or what's called the floor, also the sides, and then the roof. And what we're doing is going in there and smoothing everything out, removing any of the marks that we created with the burr and any of the casting flash. What I like to do is continue to go around as much as you can in a circular pattern, circular and spiral in there. What it does is it keeps you from grinding into one area, misshaping, but also and whether it's factual or not, it just tends to, especially on the intake here, give you the belief that as the air's coming in, it is giving a swirling effect. Now you'll notice I'm changing the rolls pretty frequently. Now there's still about half life into these, but since I only have to take about 50 steps, I'm into the warehouse. Those guys out there are great. They'll distract management, and I can get these things free all day long. You know, the main thing I like to do is, like we did the gasket matching on here, you know, get that open up to your gasket. Make sure you got the right gasket on there in proportion to what you're putting on headers or the original cast iron manifolds. All right, now that you got these things ported and cleaned up, what you want to do is actually lap your valves. And what this does is this seats the valve face to the valve seat itself. There's lapping compound, which you can see I have on my finger and the valve itself. Slide your valve in. And the nice thing to do is just take a Sharpie at this point, and you can mark the valve itself to the cylinder. This is the valve lapping tool. This is what you guys are probably familiar with. These are dime a dozen at auto parts stores. But it's used, it's suction cup on the valve, and then you continually do this. And what you're doing, the valve lapping compound itself is an abrasive, and what it's doing is it's removing a minute amount of metal. But this is tedious, and you got 16 of these things to do. So another trick, on the valve stem side itself, you can take a small cordless drill, carefully chuck it onto the valve stem. And I'm gonna show you from this side. And what you wanna do is rotate at very, very slow speed. But very slowly. I like lift up a little and bring it down onto the seat. Lift up a little, bring it down very slowly. You don't have to do that for a very long period of time at all. And also another note is put oil on the valve stem itself so you're not wearing your guide. Remove the valve, wipe off your lapping compound. And if you have a good valve to valve seat, what you'll see is a band right around the middle of the valve face area itself. All right, now that you did all those valves, now the thing to do, since you got the heads off, is go ahead. You got them flowing nice, why don't you make them look nice? This is our new high temp ceramic engine paint. We sell this in quarts. It's set up right out of the can. It can be sprayed through a spray gun, or it brushes very nice also. This is just a 1-inch foam brush. It wouldn't take very long to come here, do this entire head very easily.